The interventional endoscopy program at Yale is a group of highly skilled physicians, nurses, technicians working in a state-of-the-art facility.
To provide a compassionate care to the patient and family with excellent, consistent outcomes.
We have developed this team that really covers a broad range of the tools and techniques that are available in interventional endoscopy.
What we do as a team is to say, what do we know about the condition of this problem right now? And how could an advanced endoscopy answer some of those questions or help that patient and help the referring doctor?
So we're available all the time to talk to the physician, arrange for a prompt consultation, arrange for a prompt procedure in order to facilitate the best possible care.
We all specialize in both cancerous and non-cancerous GI conditions.
We can provide important information when there's diagnostic uncertainty, so there might be symptoms and maybe a minor change.
One of the great resources that we have in our intervention endoscopy group is that the pathologist actually comes down to our unit during the procedure, and we show the pathologist the cells that we've aspirated or biopsied. What that results in is our ability then to make decisions for the patient there and then.
In addition to diagnosis, we can also offer treatment such as pancreatic cancer, bile duct cancers, bile duct stones, pancreatic duct stones, and recurrent episodes of pancreatitis.
And they're really needy patients, and we used to do more invasive interventions for pancreatic necrosis and fluid collections 5 years ago. Now the field is evolving a lot.
These new technologies really allow us to provide very good and minimally invasive care to our patients.
One of the mainstays of the tools that we use in interventional endoscopy is a test called an ERCP, and that allows us to manage diseases of the bile duct and the pancreatic duct, such as strictures, such as difficult large gallstones. We can actually drive even smaller cameras called cholangioscopes into the bile duct to take a closer look and directly visualize that.
The other technique that's really been huge for us is endoscopic ultrasound. It's a way of getting an ultrasound transducer very close to the organ that's being affected.
So when endoscopic ultrasound first started, it was only diagnostic, and then as we had the ability to target small lesions and how it can provide new solutions.
Being able to go ahead and make the diagnosis, palliate, treat, make a prompt referral, all in the space of one visit, is very convenient for the patient.
And each patient is treated as an individual. We personalize the treatment towards that particular patient, even though we have standardized care.
There are many components to gastrointestinal tract diseases.
We work closely with radiologists and surgeons and other gastroenterologists.
Although it's evidence-based science, there's a little bit art to it, because we have to be compassionate and empathic about what the needs are. That's where the referring physician's role come into play. They really know what the patient's choice is, family's choice is. So it's a good clinical collaboration, I would say.
When a patient comes here, they're not necessarily just getting one particular view. They're getting the team's view, they're getting the group's view.
You need good endoscopists, you need excellent surgeons, you need good oncologists, you need radiation oncologists, you need good pathologists. We all have that readily available at Yale, and we all work very closely together and provide the patient with the best possible plan.